Hello students, welcome to Sankalp Learning Classes. So let us continue with our sound topic. So in the last class we have completed the reflection of sound anna complete madidvi. Iga echo concept inna discuss madana. First let us see what do you mean by echo. See, if we shout or clap near a reflecting surface like tall building or a mountain, we hear the sound, same sound again. How the सो नहीं जोर मतडिद्रे माउंटेन अथवा टॉल बिल्डिंग और इन एम्प्टी रूम सो फर्निचर एम्प्टी रूम मतडिद्रे इट विल रिफ्लेक्ट अंत हेल्तर हौदा सो दट वाट एवर द रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ साउंड व्हाट वी आर हियरिंग दट इज कॉल्ड एज व्हाट एको हियर व्हाट यू मीन बाय एको हियर द रिफ्लेक्टिंग साउंड व्हाट वी आर गेटिंग दट इज कॉल्ड एज एको इट इज कॉज्ड ड्यू टू द रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ साउंड इट इज कॉज्ड ड्यू टू द रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ साउंड हियर आयता To hear an echo clearly, the time interval between the original sound and the echo must be at least 0.1 second. See here, students. Hear what sound you are getting. Aita. So echo kelbekadre, adu echo produce aglikke. Athwa to hear it clearly between the original sound and the echo sound. Adru madhya solpa time gap irbekagutte. That time gap, that interval is 0.1 second. If it is 0.1 second, you can hear the sound as a echo anta heltare. Aita. So this is 1 mark question. What is the time interval for the echo here? That is the 0.1 second. Since the speed of sound in air is 344 meter per second, the distance traveled is equal to in the distance traveled by sound in 0.1 second is equal to 344 divided by 0.1. So 344 divided by 0.1 antandre it becomes 34.4 meter. So the distance traveled is how much? It is 34.4 meter. Anta helbodu navu illi aita. Andre to hear the sound, andre adu sound one side move agi then again to return or to reach you people, it is traveling the total distance of 34.4 meter. Andre one side ge eshtu agutte 17.2 meter agutte one side. Okay, one side ge it will be 17.2 meter. To reach and to reach the source or to reach the wall, then it is returning to your ear. It is total distance is 34.4, but the one side distance is 17.2. Andre sound source inda matte nimdu kivige aita athwa source matte what we can say source and listener, the distance is 17.2 meter. So for the entire journey it is 34.4. Right, right. Next we have the reverberation definition. What is reverberation? Let us see. See here, echoes may be heard more than once due to repeated or multiple reflections of sound from several reflecting surfaces. So echo enagutte antandre due to several reflecting surfaces we will get the reverse or the return of the sound here. This causes persistency of sound and it is called as what? Reverberation. So what is reverberation here? The sound echoes may be heard more than once due to repeated or multiple reflections of sound from several reflecting surfaces. From several reflecting surfaces, it is called as that is reverberation. Okay. So reverberation, it is nothing but what? Once due to repeated or multiple reflection, what sound you are getting? It is reverberation. So where reverberation, you can see that, or you can observe it in big halls or auditorium to reduce reverberation. The roofs and the walls are covered by sound absorbing materials like compressed fiber boards, rough plasters or draperies. Okay, so idnella use maadi nave en martivi antare reverberation anna kadme martivi. For example, cinema hall ella nodidre neevu, it is a big hall, right? So whatever that height of the roof there it is made, no, adu height of the roof mele alli reverberation agodanna naavu avoid maadlikke agutte. Okay, next we have uses of multiple reflection of sound. So how this multiple reflection is useful, see here students, sounds from the human body through a stethoscope we can hear it. How the megaphones, horns, musical instruments like trumpets and all are designed to send sound by multiple reflection in a particular direction without spreading in all directions. So illi nave en sound anna nortta idivi, it will be done based on the multiple reflection. Idu yavadu sound operating sound device nortta idivi, these are based on multiple reflection, aitha. So doctor listen to the heartbeat reaches the doctor's ears by multiple reflection antane heltare. So nave en stethoscope inda sound anna hear martivi, sound anna kelthivi by using the stethoscope. That is also because of the multiple reflection phenomena. Generally, the ceiling of cinema halls and auditoriums are curved so that sound after multiple reflection reaches all parts of the hall. Howda? So illi naavenu cinema hall anna nodta idivi athava auditorium anna nodta idivi, it reaches all parts of the hall. Sometimes a curved sound board is placed behind the stage so that sound after multiple reflection spreads evenly across the hall. Aitha? So multiple reflection, sometimes we use it and sometimes we avoid it. Based on the requirement, we can change the multiple reflection of sound in the particular area. Then the next point we have, that is range of hearing. Range of hearing antandre illi nodi kelavan sali enadru music play aagta irutte joragi ond 4-5 speaker anna itti sound play maartta idre, it is not pleasant. Howda? So idain agutte namge karkash anusute, irritate agutte. Howda? So we, why it is so, athwa kelavan sali onde speaker itte kelavan sali we feel it is very pleasant, right? So if cats are making noise, then we feel it, some people will feel it pleasant. If dogs are barking, some people will feel it as noise. So what is this range of hearing here? Then horn sound, vehicle sounds and all. See, human beings can hear sound frequencies between 20 hertz to 2000 hertz anta heltare. So human ear can hear the sound range of 20 hertz to 2000 hertz. Sound whose frequency is less than 20 hertz is called as what? Infrasonic sound. So sound waves which are having less frequency, that is 20 hertz, it is called as infrasonic sound. Animals like dogs, elephants, rhinoceros, whales, etc. produce and hear infrasonic sound. So namak kelik baruvanta sound range is 20 hertz to 2000 hertz. In that, if the sound wave frequency is less than 20 hertz, then it is called as infrasonic. Some animals can hear that. Then sound waves whose frequency is greater than 20,000 hertz is called as what? Ultrasonic. Sorry, idu 2000 hertz anta agide, illi 20,000 anta agbekadu, aita. So animals like dolphins, bats, rats produce and hear ultrasonic sound. See the next point. Bats use reflection of ultrasonic sound waves to detect an obstacle or its prey. Howda? So bats en madutte antandre, here whatever the bats are there, they will produce this ultrasonic sound. Idu sounds anna produce maadi we can hear that sound andre enagutte reflection agi adu calculate madutte andre adakke gottagutte est distance alli ಪ್ರೇಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಎನಿ ಆಬ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಕಲ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಅಂತ. ಆಯ್ತಾ? ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೌ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅವರ್ ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೌಂಡ್, ಎಕೋ ಅಂಡ್ ರಿವರ್ಬಿರೇಷನ್. ದೆನ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಯೂಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಲ್ಟ್ರಾಸೋನಿಕ್ ಸೌಂಡ್. ಸಿ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಯೂಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಲ್ಟ್ರಾಸೋನಿಕ್ ಸೌಂಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್. Ultrasonic sound is used to clean objects like electronic components. So ultrasonic sound ana ell use martare antandre electronic components alli use martare anta heltare. The components to be cleaned are kept in a cleaning solution and ultrasonic waves due to the high frequency ilenagutte antandre ultrasonic sound it is used to clean objects like electronic components. Electronic components alli ultrasonic waves anna use martare to clean the components anta helbodu. Aita the components to be cleared, the components to be cleared here are kept in a cleaning solution. ಸೊ ಅದನ್ನ ಕ್ಲೀನಿಂಗ್ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ಟು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಸೆಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸೌಂಡ್ ವೇವ್, ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಸೆಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸೌಂಡ್ ವೇವ್ಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಹೈ ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಿ ದ ಡರ್ಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಡಿಟ್ಯಾಚ್ಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಕಾಂಪೋನೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ದ ಡರ್ಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಡಿಟ್ಯಾಚ್ಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಕಾಂಪೋನೆಂಟ್ಸ್. So next, second point, see the second point. Ultrasonic sound is used to detect cracks in a metal blocks. So metal blocks alli enadru cracks idre we can detect it by using the ultrasonic sound. Ultrasonic waves are sent through the metal blocks and if there are cracks the waves are reflected back. ಆಯ್ತಾ? ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ದ ವೇವ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ವೇವ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಮ್ ಔಟ್. ಸೊ ಎಲ್ಲಾದ್ರೂ ಕ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಆ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಇಂದ ರಿಟರ್ನ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಅದು. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ದ ವೇರ್ ದ ಕ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ ಇಸ್ ಫೌಂಡ್, ವೇರ್ ದ ಕ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ ಇಸ್ ಫೌಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಲ್ಟ್ರಾಸೋನಿಕ್ ಸೌಂಡ್. ದ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಲ್ಟ್ರಾಸೋನಿಕ್ ಸೌಂಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ultrasound scanners for getting images of internal organs of the human body. So where we can use this one, we can use this ultrasonic sound to scan and to get the images of the internal organs of the human body anta helabodu. Aita so one we can use this to clean the electronic components, second one to detect the cracks, third one to get the internal organ images, fourth point ultrasonic sound is used to break small stones formed in the kidneys into fine grains so that they are removed through the urine. Aita so illi now bere bere uses anna tagolbodu by using ultrasonic sound here, right? So next, these are the last point of your topic. We are discussing about the solar here. So what do you mean by solar? See, that is, it is nothing but so here the sonar stands for sound navigation and ranging. What do you mean by sonar? The full form of sonar is what? Sound navigation and ranging. Here it is a device which uses ultrasonic waves to measure the distances. So where sonars are used, it is used to measure the distances, direction and speed of underwater objects. ಆಯ್ತಾ. ಸೊ ಇದೆಲ್ಲದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಸೋನಾರ್ ಅನ್ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೋನಾರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಎ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಮೀಟರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎ ಡಿಟೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಾಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಶಿಪ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಸೋನಾರ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಮೀಟರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಅಂಡ್ ಡಿಟೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಸೊ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಮೀಟು ಮಾಡತ್ತೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ವೇವ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಸೆಂಡ್ ಕೂಡ ಮಾಡತ್ತೆ, ಡಿಟೆಕ್ಟ್ ಕೂಡ ಮಾಡತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ. ಆಯ್ತಾ, ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ? ಶಿಪ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ದ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಮೀಟರ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ಅಲ್ಟ್ರಾಸೋನಿಕ್ ಸೌಂಡ್ ವೇವ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಟ್ರಾವೆಲ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದ ವಾಟರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆರ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೈಕಿಂಗ್ ದ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೀ ಬೆಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಟು ದ ಡಿಟೆಕ್ಟರ್. ಸೊ ಇದೇನಾಗತ್ತೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ, ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಸೆಂಡ್ ದ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ by using ultrasonic sound, then it will return back. The distance of the object can be calculated by knowing the speed of sound in water and the time taken between the transmission and reception of ultrasound. If the time taken for the transmission and reception of ultrasound is t, the distance traveled is 2d. The one side distance is d, return the distance is d, so it becomes 2d here. So distance is equal to velocity into time or speed into time. Therefore we can calculate speed is or distance is equal to v into t divided by 2. This is how we can calculate at what distance some whales or some objects, whatever it is situated by in the ships and in the seas, we can use this sonar here. Right, you remember the full form of sonar here, that is sound navigation and ranging. Then the last part of this chapter, that is structure of the human ear. So what is the structure of human ear? See this. You can see one picture. You need to remember this. Okay, so especially in biology part, you will discuss this in detail. That is, we have pinna, hammer, anvil, strip, and cochlea. ಆಯ್ತಾ, ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಇಯರ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್. ದ ಆಲ್ ವಿಲ್ ಡೂ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್. ದ ಔಟರ್ ಇಯರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ವಾಟ್? ಪಿನ್ನಾ. ಸೊ ಔಟರ್ ಇಯರ್ಗೆ ಏನಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ? ಪಿನ್ನಾ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಇಟ್ ಕಲೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ದಿ ಸೌಂಡ್ ವೇವ್ಸ್. ಇದೇನ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ, ಸೌಂಡ್ ವೇವ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಕಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. ದ ಸೌಂಡ್ ವೇವ್ಸ್ ಪಾಸಸ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದ ಇಯರ್ ಕ್ಯಾನಲ್ ಟು ಎ ಥಿನ್ ಮೆಂಬ್ರೇನ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ವಾಟ್? ಇಯರ್ ಡ್ರಮ್. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ ಹಿಯರ್? ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ದ ಸೌಂಡ್ ವೇವ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್, ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ it is collected by the pinna, later it is sent to the ear drum. Aita, the ear drum vibrates. So yavaga idu sound waves hogi ear drum ge touch agutte, it will start vibrating, and the vibrations are the vibrations of amplitude by the three bones. So illi ear drum alli three bones irutte idakke attach agi. One is middle ear called as hammer, anvil, and stirrup. Aita, these are the three bones here which is there inside the ear. The middle ear then transmit the sound waves to the inner ear. So first enagutte, sound collected by the pinna, later it is sent to the eardrum. So eardrum alli three bones ide, one is hammer, anvil, and stirrup. Aita, so middle ear en madutte antandre, it will transmit the sound wave to the inner ear. It will transmit the sound to the inner ear. In the inner ear, the sound waves are converted into electrical signals. So inner ear alli enagutte, the sound waves will get converted into electrical signals by the cochlea. Aita, so sound waves get converted into electrical signals in the cochlea. It is sent to the brain through the auditory nerves. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲೇನಾಗತ್ತೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೆಂಡ್ ಟು ದ ಬ್ರೈನ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದ ಆಡಿಟರಿ ನರ್ವ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಬ್ರೈನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಇಂಟರ್ಪ್ರೇಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಸೌಂಡ್. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಲೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಪಿನ್ನಾ, ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೆಂಡ್ ಟು ದ ಇಯರ್ ಡ್ರಮ್. ದೇರ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ತ್ರೀ ಬೋನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಮಿಡಲ್ ಬೋನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫರ್ ಇಟ್ ಟು ದ ಇನ್ನರ್ ಇಯರ್, ಅಂಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಇನ್ನರ್ ಇಯರ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೆಂಡ್ ಟು ದ ಕೊಕಿಲಿಯ, where it is sent to the nerves and to the brains. Finally it will get detected as a sound by the brain, right? So this is how we can explain the structure of ear. So this completes the entire chapter of your sound here. I hope the concepts are clear to you. Once again, note down the points. So the structure of ear, it is important for 2 mark. Go through it. If you remember and able to write this one paragraph also, it is good. So now let us discuss the question answers which are there in between the chapter. So the first question is, first question we have, how does the sound produced by a vibrating object in a medium reach your ear? So first question is, ಹೌ ಡಸ್ ದ ಸೌಂಡ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ವೈಬ್ರೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಮೀಡಿಯಂ ರಿಚ್ ಯುವರ್ ಇಯರ್ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಸಿ ಹೌ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ರಿಚ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದ ಏರ್. ಹೌದಾ, ಸೊ ಏರ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಕಾಮನ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ material through which sound propagates. Through sound, the air, through the sound, the air will propagate here. When vibrating objects like prongs of tuning fork move forward, they push the molecules of the air in front of them. This in turn compresses the air, thus creating a region of high pressure and high density. It is called as what? Compression. This compression in the air travels forward. This compression in the air travels forward here. When the prongs of the tuning fork move backward, when it moves backward, they create a region of low pressure in the air, and it is commonly called as what? Rarefaction. See here, how the when the compression region is there, the pressure will be more. When the rarefaction region is there, the pressure will be less here. This is how the sound is produced in the medium, then it will reach our ear. Then the next question is, explain how sound is produced by your school bell. So very simple and interesting answer. Air is the common most material through which the sound propagates. Idu namge gottide, through air the sound is getting produced. When school bell is rung, it pushes the molecules of the air in front of it. So what it will do, it will push the molecules of the air into in front of it. This in turn compresses the air. This in turn compresses the air here, thus creating a region of high pressure and high density. It is called as what? Compression. This compression in the air, it travels in the forward direction, and when bell moves back, it creates a region of low pressure, and it is commonly called as rarefaction. This region has low pressure, low density. Hoda, when the bell continues to vibrate, the region of compression and the rarefaction is producing. These regions alternate at the same place. The energy of vibrating bell travels outward. This energy, which reaches the ears, makes the eardrums to vibrate, and thus we hear the sound. We hear the sound in this way. So not only based on the school bell, if it is asked for different any other source of sound also, we can explain in the same way here. Then let us see the next question. Why are sound waves are called mechanical waves? So yedakke now sound waves ige mechanical waves anta heltivi, see here. Because the sound wave require medium for its propagation, therefore it is called as what? Mechanical wave. Therefore it is called as mechanical wave. Okay, then next question. Suppose you and your friend are on the moon, will you be able to hear any sound produced by your friend? No. Yakantandre allenu space allenu air illa athwa ene medium illa anodrinda we cannot hear the sound there. Okay, so it is not possible to hear the sound if there is no atmosphere. Then the next question, which have which wave property determines loudness and pitch? So now theoretically discuss madidvi, frequency matte pitch ge relation ide. High frequency high pitch, low frequency low pitch anta. Loudness, that is the amplitude of the wave determines the loudness. More the amplitude, more is the loudness. Aita, then the next question is, guess which sound has a higher pitch, whether it is guitar or a car horn. So obviously we know that the car horn has a higher pitch than the guitar, because sound produced by the former is shriller than the latter. Right? So here we can say that that is car horn is having the higher pitch or higher frequency anta kuda helabodu. Then the next question is, what are wavelength, frequency, time period, amplitude? So yella just a definition barudde aitu. See, wavelength antandre it is the distance between two consecutive crest or trough. It is called as what? Wavelength. What is frequency? The number of oscillations in 1 second, it is called as frequency. What is time period? The time taken to complete one oscillation, it is called as time period. What is amplitude? The maximum displacement of a vibrating particle about its mean position, it is called as amplitude. Right? So these are the terms which we learned in the chapter itself. Next, how are the wavelength and frequency of sound wave related to its speed? So speed matte wavelength matte frequency relation kelta idare. So speed is equal to, it is frequency into wavelength. Frequency into wavelength it is, okay? Then the next question is, calculate the wavelength of a sound wave whose frequency is 220 hertz and the speed is 440 meter. So speed they have given it as 440, frequency is 220. Let us calculate the wavelength. What is the relation between all three? That is speed is equal to wavelength into frequency. Our nimginle en kelthidare nodi, they are asking you to calculate wavelength. Therefore wavelength is equal to speed divided by wave frequency. So we will get it as speed divided by wavelength. 440 divided by 220. It is 0, 0 will get cancelled. Therefore, it is 22 ones are 22 tubes. So 2 meter is the wavelength anta helabodu. So see here, I can write and show you. We know that the relation is speed is equal to frequency into wavelength. They are asking you to calculate wavelength. Therefore, it is speed divided by frequency. Speed is how much? It is 440 divided by. Frequency is how much? It is 220. 0, 0 will get cancelled. 22 ones are 22 twos are. So, it is 2 meter. Wavelength is how much? It is 2 meter. Anta helabodu namage. Aita? Aita? Okay, so here we have a numerical. This numerical we will do in the next class. Okay, students.